so interesting to start your day on a long, extremely difficult par three. But that was a beautiful start.
Oh, yes.
Second player off the tee, playing out of Las Vegas, Nevada.
I've just recently gotten into that a little bit. Not, I don't design golf courses, but just kind of really appreciating some of the designs I've been able to play and what's gone into that. That's a beautiful putt there. I was looking at the stats from last year in 2023, similar hole location.
Hole location just back right today, 29 paces on, four off that right-hand side. So should be able to see the hole really easily from where he was standing.
And that left for an opening, well, his first birdie of the week.
10.
We're going to go back to that. Keep mentioning that. That's an easy birdie for Taylor Montgomery. That's the start you're looking for.
Coming off his win, his third career win.
Pro Core. Long stretch in between wins.
Yeah, that's well done there.
That was very nice. I don't want it to. Patton after that awesome bunker shot.
That's nicely done.
Want to hit so close to the ball and spin it any much. Peter Malnati from dead center of the fairway.
Yeah, hole location just on the front today. Seven on and four off that right-hand side. That's a beauty.
The opposite.
Really?
I honestly didn't know that you could stick a ground and probe around.
Yeah, for anybody watching, it's really nice to know, too. It doesn't mean you're going to get relief just because you find one. But you heard him say, I just want to brace myself for the hit.
Nick Dunlap, John.
Well, that's just a sand wedge, and he's looking for something good to happen. Nothing good has happened yet. Oh, that kick forward off the fringe was good, though.
Yeah, that had a small error there. Yep. Nick Dunlap's third from 127 out.
Yeah, had to lay it up to this point from a deep lie in the rough.
Oh.
And that works.
Hey, more than one way to skin a cat. Susie, maybe a touch on the top. Maybe a break where you see he's in that cart track, and it's probably laid the grass with him, which, there you go.
Well, that might turn things around for him.
120 feels like a number that guys practice a lot too. Like, oh, 120, that's really good. It's like 100 yards on the button. Every tour player has a 100-yard shot. See?
Yes.
See?
Such a good call.
See if he can get a little draw over to this left-hand flag. That's his shot.
Line looked awfully good.
Yeah.
How about it? How about it? Just wait it out. Be patient. It'll be fine.
Kazire dialed in again. You have pointed out his wedges, and he has got them going.
Over this stretch. Maybe the last six will be good.
Yeah, dude.
There you go.
Oh, well, that's a good start.
It's a birdie all the way.
There's two ways to get the ball up and down, BK. You got to do the up part well or the down part well. You don't have to do both well.
He was 1-3 in his matches, but that stage just gives you a whole different sense of confidence.
That is a wonderful shot here at four. Getting better.
Come on. Come on. Oh, man.
And still wasn't done. Mackenzie Hughes just stuffs it. That's going to tie him for the lead.
David Skinns is going haywire out on the golf course. And you can't go low without making a few putts. This was his birdie attempt on four.
Yeah, third in a row on the front nine alone. Six birdies on the back. Hole location just on the front of the screen, five paces on, six off the right-hand side. And I have a feeling we're going to go to 10.
Yeah, that's called being in the zone right there.
Now at the seventh, and that sub-60 round is in sight if he can get this long one to go.
difficult par three here. You know, he's got to be thinking about it at this point. And now he's really thinking about it, making a bomb there on seven. Two holes.
The leader, David Skinns. This is second on the eighth hole, his 17th.
Yeah, this is from just 135 yards. I mean,
well,
this round any good?
Yeah. Solid putt. Hit a solid putt. No. All that for nothing.
Oh, goodness. Well, right. That's the worst, too. You shoot 60 and you feel bad about it.
Yeah, you're like, what a dog I am. It's all about the tee shot, you know?
All about the tee shot.
But he hasn't hit fairways.
On the golf course, but he's not in fairways. That's a great point by you.
There we go.
First tour card from 1997. I'm holding it. You just handed it
to me. That's it. That's how important it is.
Wow.
This was like the best gift I ever got in my life when it showed up in the mail after Q school. And you get an actual tour card. The tour. Your tryout period's over. Time to burn.
I got the height he needed maybe to get this to stop.
Mm-hmm. And it did.
Earned his way here through three wins on the Corn Ferry Tour. Best putter on the Corn Ferry Tour, stats-wise, this year. And gets his first birdie.
Nothing's promised to you. You know, it doesn't matter how good you are or you feel you are, you're not promised another win. So that thought has to creep in. And it has to creep into somebody like Ricky's head. I don't know that I'll ever win again. I think I will. And I learned the opposite. My dad always taught me, don't aim. Well, get closed up. Always kind of play the way like a Trevino or a Couples did, which is aim more left. Yep. John Vegas. Three. Harris. Cooch.
Fowler. Just a wedge from 147.
There we go. Someone loved it.
Third shot. We'll try to make the next one for par. Now Glover.
Fancy little strike with a bunch of spin. See, that just spun right in place. That was very cool.
Yeah, longer putt here for Matt. It's that whole location, I can't imagine, fits a left-hander quite as well. But an uphill look there. And guys are liking the long uphill putts here at 13. I'm giving Dawes a little shout-out on that read as caddy. Great read there, Dawes.
That's his caddy. Dev, we heard his voice.
Okay.
This 18th, one of the difficult driving holes on the course. You see 480 yards, good length hole, but you hit the fairway like Gary just did and it becomes a birdie hole. That's what's great about this golf course.
At the par five, he was one under at one point. He's had a little bit of a tough go here as the round has worn on. But here's his third at the par five, 14th, and that is gorgeous. Golf Central, by the way, comes up immediately following our coverage of the first round of the Sanderson Farms Championship at the top of the hour, and we will figure out and find out exactly how Reed Hughes finishes up this first round. The 71-year-old who qualified for this Sanderson Farms Championship. It's been an amazing story watching him all the way come down the stretch. Make sure you finish up with Golf Central coming up next here on Golf Channel.
Thanks for watching the PGA Tour on YouTube. Watch another video right here.